How's it going, guys? I'm Oz, and welcome back to another episode of Ozzy's Mailbag! The episode where you guys send me stuff, and I get to open it, which is all very exciting. Now, today we've actually got a few parcels, and you'll see little Lemon here. It's quite windy today, so he's been a bit hyperactive and stuff. He keeps obviously hearing, like, the roof creak and all that sort of thing, so he's like... It's quite funny. You okay, buddy? Yeah, you're okay. Yeah, he's okay. So, we've got a few parcels here, which is really exciting. I was only expecting two, but I've got four! Four! So, it's really good to see so many, because at the moment, I've just received the bill to have the PO box, you know, because I lease it for a year. It's a yearly lease, and so I just got the bill again, so it's a couple hundred dollars. I have been aware about it for a while, so I'll just use the funds that I've been saving up for like the last 6 months on YouTube to use towards that. So thank you guys so much for sending me mail. I really, 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 really appreciate it. I think it's been worthwhile having it. It's the first year that we've had it, so it's like 1 year anniversary for us. And you know, I've been able to experience so much about you guys, as well as about the world and what we're living in and the culture and things. And I think it's just been a really, really fantastic way of us physically connecting. So thank you so much for everyone that sends me mail. Look in the description if you guys want to send me mail. I'm going to keep it open. So please send me stuff, even if it's just a letter. I don't expect parcels. I mean, obviously it's cool, but just receiving a letter and a picture. I really love it when you guys send me a picture of yourself, so then I know who's writing to me. That to me means a real massive deal. I would really, really appreciate a letter. So thank you guys so much to everyone that sent me mail, and thank you to hopefully the rest of you that will hopefully send me a letter. Yay! So without further ado, let's get started. So let's start with the top one. Now, this one is from Magic. So Magic, Magic sent me the piano. I'm pretty sure that was Magic. Yes, I just had a massive blonde moment. So anyway, I'm pretty sure that was him. So what was really interesting about this parcel is that on the back of it, it actually says that it was opened by Australia Post Customs. So I think it got flagged. So I'm really interested to see what's in it. I hope nothing was confiscated from it. So Magic, you need to let me know if anything has been, and they've really poorly put it all back together again. I don't know. Maybe they just didn't like it was from Poland. I've got no idea, but something obviously flagged them, so. Oh my goodness me. What in the world have we got? Read first. Mine. Yeah. Ah, shit sticks. I love it. Magic writes all this stuff on there, like all of my... Oh, so he keeps writing. You guys really like things that I say. I don't know what it is, but righto, gonna end it here. Oh wait, what's this? It's for the crumbs. It's for the crumbs. You guys are really seriously love my toaster thing. Oh, it's so good. Hysterical laughter and Lemon, mine. Heaps and heaps of people. When did I say that? So where do we go here? Where do I need to go? That's something I say a lot in my playthroughs. It's like, oh, I'm so lost. Okay. Gotta be very careful with this. Okay. Oh, goodness, there's a few papers in there. Oh, no, there's heaps of photos. Yay. That's nothing else. Good. Okay. Here we go. Smells interesting. I mean, obviously it smells like paper, but it smells... anyway, sorry. My warmest greetings to you, Dinny, worshipper of the almighty Lemon, discoverer of hidden toaster latches, ferocious shinies collector, and creator of an awesome YouTube channel. Oh, that's an entry and a half. Thank you. Here's me writing to you again, including some goodies all the way from Poland. I hope you like them. First, I apologize for being an utter tosspot because I forgot the photo and the last letter. Yes, you did. I remember now. So to atone, here's three. Three! Oh, sweet. In one of them, I am all suited up for my spy mission. Kidding. It's from Autumn 2015, and I was at a friend's wedding. Another one is from a plane, and is probably the most recent one. Finally, a bit of competition. You like your toaster panels. I like my tangerines. Life's little pleasures. On the goodies then. Polish-themed goodie party part 2. Oh, okay. I've noticed that apart from foreign currency, you like maps, so I've attached one from my hometown. I'm not even going to pronounce it. And I'll make sure you pronounce it this time. Oh, the Z after the S and C. Make it harder sounding, so try. Pershnichna. Oh, Pershnichna. It's in Pershnichna. Isn't that in a movie? They mention it. Some woman mentions it. Maybe. I feel like it's from House, you know, Dr. House. Pershnichna, something like that. While being in the tourist center, I also picked some coasters for your green tea, of course. Oh, brilliant, I needed a coaster. Also, a brochure in English with some basic info about the town with my comments. Oh, cool. So, the other one goodie is a Polish theme to it too, but I'm not sure if it's safe for you to have it. Oh. I mean, we've seen it in live streams that you develop quite an addiction towards these. I know it's an English version of this, but I couldn't for the life of me get a hold of them. So you'll have to accept the Polish descriptions, but artwork itself should put a smile on your face. I wonder if Custom stole that. I don't know. That's it then in this one. I'll say this again, you have an awesome channel, and I think I speak on behalf of many when I say that I appreciate you posting new content. I'm sorry, I haven't posted any for a while. We all love your reactions, I should say. You know you're crazy special in a good way. All the best to you, Matt and Lemon. Take care, Magic. Fun fact, in Croatian, my name is not so different than the word Maka, which means cat. Oh, how interesting is that? There you go, Lemon. He's just like, so, you're looking all serious then? Look at him all suited up. I like the picture in the background. It's rather interesting. And then, oh, tangerine. You mean orange. No, margarine. Mandarin. We call them mandarines. And then you want to play, because Magic's always on planes. Always on planes. So we always talk together on Discord and Twitch TV. So I really love how you're such an active member of the community, Magic. It's really, really good. Thank you so much for being with us. And Kosta! I haven't even seen it. Here we go. Brishichna. Oh, fuck, that's bad. I meant my accent's bad, not the coaster. I love the coaster. So it's actually a coaster of his little hometown. I guess that's the church or something. Kosta! Thank you! I'll put that there. I'll open that up later and I'll actually use it. Okay. Ooh. Oh, there's more coasters, guys! Oh, there's another... Oh! I thought there was only one. And there's one with a bull. If you send me 4 more, I'll have like one for every day of the week. Yay! They're so cool, thank you so much. I think that's it. Okay, and then the other one. Oh, this is the thing, the information booklet with some of his comments. I'll have to read that again sometime, because I can't really read them all now. But, here we go. So, it's got pictures of, like, the gardens. Oh, there's a place, Old Town Winter. Apparently there's a really, really good ice cream store there. So if you live in Poland, you should know about that. Or if you're planning to go to Poland. You know, if I ever get to Poland, Magic, we'll go and get some ice cream together. What do you reckon? You've got a lot of old, like, buildings and houses and things like that. It looks like a really interesting museum. So... the armory in the Gothic basement. How cool. Look at her. She's like, I reckon I could do that pose. You ready? Hang on. Oh, there's... good for a walk or bike ride. It does look nice. It's Castle Gardens or something like that. Castle Park. The water looks beautiful. Paper smells nice. No monsters or witches here. I'm obsessed with The Witcher at the moment. It's crazy. I haven't played it for a while because I think people got bored of watching me play it on Twitch TV, which is so sad because it's such an amazing game. I love it so much. Any balls? So you guys have a lot of, like, bison breeding. Okay. Oh. Neurosaurus. Why do they breed the bison? Doesn't exactly... it probably says it in there somewhere. And more churches and all that sort of thing. Oh, look at that. Very cool. Oh, they got skate parks and theme runs and all sorts of bits and pieces. That's awesome. There's a picture of golfing up here. And Magic said, for posh people who like to play with small balls. Oh, that's funny. Oh, I like that. Okay, and then we've got the tourist map. Did you mark where you live? How else am I going to stalk you? Eh. Bloody hell. Okay. I don't know if you mark where you live. Is this all of Poland or just like one bit of it? Here we go. Map of Poland. You know, one day, I'm just gonna have to like open my own museum with all of your stuff in there, guys, because I would love to be able to hang all of these posters and stuff on the wall, but they're just so big. They're very cool though. I'm keeping them in like a little booklet and things. Keep it all together. What's in here? Ooh. It's a Witcher thing. Magic! Oh my god! I got squint cards! Oh my god! Oh my god! I'm like shaking so much. I don't want to open them, but I have to open them. It goes against all my rules as like a collector of so many things, like to just keep them in packages. But oh my god, I've always wanted. Ah! Oh, that's the perfect spy. I want that spy because basically with the spy, you put it on the other side of the map, and you gain two cards in your hand deck and stuff. And it's good because when you put a card on their side, it can sometimes give them damage. But because it's got a zero value up there, sorry. Oh my god! Ah, oh, Siri. Oh my god, she is so bae. Like, seriously? Who wouldn't want that? Like, oh my god, Siri. So good. Oh my god. This is so surreal. Oh my god. Where the hell did you get these? Oh, and you got Geralt of Rivia. Ah, this is wicked. Oh my god. You know what I'm going to have to do now? I'm going to have to buy an album. You know, like what you did with Pokemon cards and stuff like that can fit these Gwent cards. And so I can have them all displayed out. Oh, I'm going to have to look on eBay later and see if I've got one. Oh, they smell so good. Oh man, now I know which cards to collect. Because I haven't, there's a challenge on Thingamabobs on Witcher to collect all the cards. Ugh. Oh, and you've got all the leaders in here as well. Oh, this is so good. Oh my god, thank you so much. And we've got a monster deck as well. Monsters are bitches diverse, but as long as you've got Bite and Frost in you. Anyway, sorry. Thank you so much, Magic. Oh, just that is so wicked. I'll open up the monster ones later because I don't want to bore people who don't like The Witcher. Thank you so much. Oh my god. And then they got a little bag. Now, that's all that's been sent to me, so I hope that nothing else has been stolen. Because it's hard to know when... Seen live stream, they developed quite an addiction towards these. I think that must be the Gwent card, so I'm hoping that they didn't steal anything else. Maybe it was the Gwent cards that they... And then, of course, he sent me a little bag as well. Budapest, Hungary. I don't know what that's for. But thank you anyway. I can use it for my shopping. Righto. So that was all from Magic. Magic. I keep calling Magic. Magic, Magic. Magic, Magic, Magic. Sorry. Thank you, mate. Gwent cards at last! Oh my god. So let's move on to the next parcel. Hello. So this one here is from Mayan from Canada. I don't know, it's from CA, maybe Eureka, United States. Whoops. you get really awkward when you say Canada instead of America and I got a letter. This is awkward. Letter. Whoa! Maybe a letter in this one. No, that hasn't been opened before. Well, okay. I guess I won't get a letter then. Maybe it's in something else. I don't know. Maybe it's in with this stuff. I don't know. No, it doesn't look like it. Oh my god. Okay, so this is from Mayan? M-A-Y-I-N. And so what he or she has given me are two games. So I've got Resident Evil 2 Revelations, which isn't even in Australia. I haven't seen this in EB Games or anything like that. So, I've got no idea. Is that like a remake of Resident Evil? Because I thought there was like 6 or 7 of them now. So, wicked. I could totally play that. And then, oh, we've got the Resident Evil Origins Collection. I don't have this Origins Collection, I should say. This is not available in Australia. I haven't seen this. Wicked. I guess we're going to be doing this as a live stream. Thank you so much. And then the other thing we've got in here... is money. It's American money, so this is so cool. So we've got a dollar bill. We've got actually lots of dollar bills. I wonder if this is all like laced with cocaine. Apparently most of the notes in America are laced with cocaine. That's what I've heard. And that one. Imagine what... Oh no, they're the same thing on each side. Oh no, this one's got... This one's got bird. No, they both have birdies. Why has it got a pyramid on there? The Illuminati. The Lemonati. So, oh, goodness me. So they're all $1 ones. And then he sent, or he, she has sent a $5 one as well. In gold, which was... There we go. Thank you so much. Wow. I was not expecting those games whatsoever. Thank you so much. I'm definitely going to play those. They will be wicked. So, I've been having a lot of problems with my capture card. So, long story short, I can't download any new games. Hopefully, these don't need too much of an update. But if they can just be installed onto my PlayStation, then obviously it doesn't require my internet passage. So, thank you so much for sending those. I will definitely play them because apparently Resident Evil is an absolute classic game and I haven't played them before, so that's fantastic. And I'm serious, like I have not seen those games in Australia, so maybe there just isn't as much demand for Resident Evil in Australia than there is America. So I don't know what's with that, but thank you so much for sending it. That's so exciting. I can't wait. Oh, wow. Okay, so let's get on with the next one. And please send me a letter. Mayan, please. This one's a bit heavier. So this one... Oh! This must be from Plot Twitch. Maybe. It looks like it's from France. Comment ça va? No, I didn't say that right. Comment ça va? Bad. Okay, let's see if I... Oh, beg your pardon. There was also something else from my end. There was this ring. The one ring to rule them all. It says... Parvis Magna Sic, or... And then some numbers on the inside. 29th of January, 1596. I don't understand what that's about. Maybe it's got something to do with... Is that from Francis Drake? From Uncharted? Ooh, I feel so bad. That must be from Francis Drake, right? Please explain that in the thing. Okay, so thank you for sending that as well. And if it is from Thingamabobs, then I'll try and wear it. Is it my... Cool. I'll try and wear it in my, I'll remember to wear it in my Uncharted 4 playthrough. So I will be playing Uncharted 4. Mark has kindly, he hasn't donated yet, but apparently he's going to, so don't let me down now, Mark. donate the money for me to be able to buy Uncharted 4, because it's going to be like 110 bucks here in Australia, and I really don't have the money for that after spending so much on my PO box, so thank you, Mark. I really, really appreciate it. How in the world do you open this box? Hmm? Oh. Oh. That was easy. Oh my goodness me. Oh. What the fuck was that? Oh god, you guys are gonna... Yeah. Wow. I don't know if I can do that, but Okay, I presume this is the letter. Oh my god. Yep, that's everything there. You look so French. You look nothing like I imagined you to. I don't know why. I don't know what I had in mind. Okay. Bonjour, Dini. Bonjour. I follow you since I found you by chance in a montage of YouTubers reacting to Valiant Hearts ending. Your genuine reactions, your authenticity, and your investment in the games you play makes you the best representation of what real gamer is. I kept watching you laugh. What's whim? Whim, fail, get pissed on, and scared even... ever since, and it's been really entertaining. Your writing is so different. But please don't get heart attacks on horror games again. We were worried. Yeah, I think I was kind of surprised that I worried so many of you. Like, I think you guys were more angry that I kept playing than like... Yeah, that was really surprising. I'll try not to go through that again. I'm a 30-year-old French guy who works in a furniture factory. I pick the stuff needed by the company's warehouses of the country. Mostly heavy kitchen pants? Parts. And stack them on one of these things, a pallet. Them off to the trucks, and then send them off to the trucks. I hope your channel grows enough to become self-sufficient, because you really deserve it, mate. It is Plot Twitch. Raise those paws more. Oh, here we go. In this parcel you will find one shirt of the Meow order. Hope it fits. One can of chestnut spread. Oh, that's what that is. It's quite sugary and goes well with dairy products, yogurts, white cheese. Mate, I'm lactose intolerant. We'll see how it goes. One can of duck legs. Translated from the can. put the legs in a big plate at room temperature. With a spoon, take as much grease as possible and store this grease in the fridge. It's good to cook other things such as potatoes. Heat it in the oven at 210 degrees in a fry pan with some thyme on, the skin side. One Kinder Shiny's egg, info inside. One map of France, stuff about France. A couple of postcards of the country I live in. It's the oldest. It's the oldest something of France. Most of them being ancient volcanoes. Mountains? Maybe mountains? My face, the auto printing machine? Made it dark. Oh, printing machine. Printing machine. So this is Plot Twitch here. And he's another person that's really, really, really regular on my Discord, as well as Twitch TV and all that sort of thing. So again, thank you so much for being a really, really active member of the community. Much appreciated. We love cheese. I can't even find the official number of existing French cheeses. Existing. It goes from 300 to 1600. Excuse me. Here's the five AOP of my region. Appellation d'Orange Protégé, something like that. It gives strict rules to able to make them. We're obsessed with roundabouts, no idea why half of the roundabouts of the world are in France. Wow. We have the most exotic places who counts as departments of territories. Oh, okay, something along those lines. Yeah. Yeah, I love the chateaus that you guys have. The gardens and stuff that you guys have are just amazing. He's like, I can't think of another interesting thing, so here's a guy putting a breadstick into a cannon. Wonderful. Flippin'. We elect a new idiot every 5 years. Oh, that's good. I like that. Okay. So, lemon, come on boy. I don't know why, he just did a full roundabout just to sniff the fan, just to go back to his chair again. Absolute spastic. So there's the couple of postcards. And then that one. That mountain is absolutely beautiful. How cool. And then we've got the map of France. I love to go to France one day. I used to study French back in college and high school, but it was more serious in college. I think I've got it upside down. Yeah. Dang it, dang it. Oh, look at that. I want to go to Lyon. Where's Lyon? Because that's where my French teacher used to live. Bordeaux. Where's Paris? I can't find it. It's pretty big. I didn't think it was as big as that. I'll be out there in a minute. Thank you. It's a map of France. Scared the crap out of me. Okay. What else have we got? There's something in this thing. Oh! No way. Oh good, it's a medium. That might be a bit small though. But it's our first official t-shirt! That is so cool. I'll try it on later and see if it fits me. I'm normally a medium, but I am getting pretty chunky lately, so. Thank you so much, that's so cool! How did you get that made? That is so cool. It's really good to see you guys getting really on board with the idea of the lemonati. I like that. And so this is the hazelnut thing, I presume. Mmm. This is gonna be interesting. Oh, chestnut spread. And this is the duck legs. I love duck. But I've never eaten it out of a can before, so I'm gonna have to talk to you on stream about how to. I know you wrote the instructions, but we're gonna have to do it as a Cooking with Oz episode. That's a good idea. That's a really good idea. That's gonna be really interesting. But thank you, Twitch, and I look forward to talking to you again soon. Say Twitch, everyone. Dot Twitch. Thank you so much. Oh my god. Ugh, this has been a long episode. God forbid I ever get more than like 4 passes at a time. Oh, lemon's getting into the box again. You can spend all your money you want on like toys and things, but there's no point, guys. Just give a cat a cardboard box. Even just a child. If you've got kids, I'm sure you would know that. So this one's from England. Maybe it's just a box to, I don't know, store the stuff in? Because I don't know why someone... Because I opened that, okay, and it said electric blanket, and I'm kind of like, yeah, okay. But, there's a message on the back. Okay, ignore this box. It was just a convenient size, and I've not got you an electric blanket. I was gonna say that would be a particularly weird thing for someone living in England to give to a relative stranger who lives in Tasmania, don't you think? Besides, the plugs wouldn't fit. Oh, I didn't think about that. Yeah, they wouldn't fit. God, how much bubble wrap do you need, mate? What in the world is this? Ah, there's a letter. Hang on, I gotta get the letter. Lemon. Oh, I forgot Twitch's thing. Hang on. There's a problem with lemon. I need get the butt out of the way. Okay, over there. Just for another couple minutes, young man. So I forgot Twitch's Nickelodeon. Kinder surprise thing. Hang on. Oh, what's in here? Oh. Is there like a couple of things in here? I just gotta make sure there isn't. Oh. Oh, okay. Oh, this is so cute. Ah. So there's this little coin in there. Not exactly little, it's huge. And that's... Oh, 50 francs. So how much is that in like terms of dollars? And then... There's a couple of little statue things. Aren't they cute? A little puppy dog. Or wolf thing. And then the other one's like a little puppy dog. It's a bit blurry, sorry. But they're really cute. Gotta make sure that lemon doesn't eat them. Hang on, let me put it up. Or my thing. Thank you, Twitch. Sorry I didn't open it up earlier. I just saw it there and I'm like, oh crap, gotta get them. Okay. French magazine. God, the paper smells so weird from around the world. Read me first. Well, that was easy to open. Hi there, Ginny, and greetings from the UK. I've been enjoying your channel for a couple of years. Watching you play scary games is most fun. Yeah, totally. And I thought you might appreciate this somewhat bulky gift. I'm a big fan of video game music, so often I get the soundtracks of games that I really enjoyed. I was a couple of years late to the Bioshock games, but still pre-infant. Infinite. Yeah. And after completing both, I looked about for the soundtracks. I found the special version of Bioshock 2 came with the soundtrack for both, amongst other very nice bonuses, and was available for no more than the price of any regular new game, so I quickly ordered it. What I did not do was look very closely at the format that the music would be presented in, hence my surprise when this rather large box arrived. Recently I thought I'd send you a copy, as this has to be the classiest special edition of any game I've seen. To be continued inside. Okay. So this is Bioshock 2 Special Edition. Oh my god. It's got a picture of like a butterfly with like little handprints and stuff on the front. It's very eerie. Me second. No way. Okay. Now you've had a look and hopefully everything crossed the planet intact, I'll mention the flaws. Maybe hasn't arrived intact. The record is probably a bit fragile compared to the rest. You probably don't have a record player anyway. I could try and find one. My mom does have one. I doubt a PAL version of a game is any good to you upside down in Upside Down Land. One of the best parts of Bioshock 2 is Minerva's Den Story DLC, which did not work with my special edition ROM code. So it's working for you is even less likely, but the DLC is a must. So I basically sent you something that may well be mostly useless, but hey, I brought it primarily for its look. Onto me. I'm a 34-year-old chocolatier. I mostly finish wedding and birthday cakes from Manchester in the UK, and my YouTube channel is Chocolate Rob. I haven't seen that one. I started my channel simply to comment under videos, but did post a few trailers for games I like too. Yeah. One of my quirks years ago was to occasionally record gameplay onto VHS. I'm showing my age. Wow. So I would watch the plots as movies at any time. With DVD recorders and free movie making programs, I tried posting my videos on YouTube to some success and made several plot walkthroughs. Lemon! No, not with the bubble wrap. No. No, no, no. Bad lemon. God, guys, it's bad having him in here. For my favourite narrative games, while I don't do it anymore, too much hassle. I'm still very pleased with the ones I did. My basic style was to record cutscenes with just enough gameplay footage to flesh them out into movies and to remove anything that would break immersion, such as subtitles and prompts. And then when posting, I'd fill the info boxes with as many interesting extras as I could cram in. Nowadays, I'm back to just watching vids, but my main series were Vagrant Story, best scripted, most beautiful medieval James Bondian RPG ever. Never heard of it. Legacy of Kain, best voiced time-traveling vampire test in the action series ever. Again, never heard of it. Prince of Persia, Sands of Time trilogy. My brother played that as a kid, so I'm familiar somewhat with that. Inspiration for all modern parkour games and another great time-traveling yarn. If you want to try out, then VS is the best and shortest. VS. Vagrant Story, okay. One game only, but still around 3 hours. Now I've covered myself and the main gift, but there's still much more. For extra bonus, lift out the casing to see what is stashed beneath. Goodness. Lemon! Cut it out! God damn. Okay, so there's more. Let's see if the record's still intact. Wow. That is seriously cool. That is seriously, seriously cool. That's one seriously special edition. Oh, so cool. I'd never guess in a million years that I'd get something like that. Wow. And this is the art book of Bioshock 2, which is probably ruining it for me. Because I've never played Bioshock 2 when I need to. Wow. Okay, stop spoiling. Oh god. The sounds. And then there's Bioshock 2 for PlayStation 3 in here as well. Wicked. Although I'll probably play it on, it's easier for me to record it on PC. But it'd be a lot easier for me to play it on, and a poster. Oh, cool. So, I gotta lift out the thing, apparently. Oh, wow. Oh my god, you guys have really spoiled me. And me last. Wow. Okay. So with the recent sad passing of David Bowie, I had to throw in one other game. I'm not a PC gamer myself, but when I learned that David Bowie would be appearing in and providing songs for Omicron, The Nomad Soul, I had to make an exception. It's the first game from David Cage and Quantic Dream, now known for Heavy Rain and Beyond Two Souls. An early version of a now common sandbox, in this one you're exploring a dystopian city in a parallel world by body surfing your soul into different characters. Okay. You can stop the occasional robbery, take part in underground tournaments for money. Take part in underground tournaments for money, watch underground David Bowie concerts, look for flyers about the Dreamers, buy Bowie songs to listen to at home, and watch TV, radio, holographic thingies, all a bit timed by the tech of 1999, but a unique game ahead of its time. Been years since I last played it. I've also thrown a few pieces from Bioshock Infinite Special Edition. Nice, but I didn't feel the game as much as the originals. I haven't really played the original, so I can't make a comment on that yet. Two pieces from Silent Hill, both I've used as posters, but I'm passing them on. One of them is from playable demo of Silent Hill that came with the Metal Gear Solid and has a great narrative set up for the first game. Even if you don't watch anything else from my channel, please look up Silent Hill 1 trailer and maybe Fatal Frame 2. It kickstarted my love of the Silent Hill series, and especially its music. The track playing over the top is called She and is still my favourite instrumental from the series. The trailer itself is a great atmospheric setup. Anyway, I've a bit bad habit of rattling on, so I'll stop now. Enjoy the presents, Robert. Thank you so much, Robert. I don't mind people rattling on, because to be quite honest, I rattle on a fair bit. So there we go. We can rattle on together. So this is the Soul game that he was talking about by Quantic Dream, and a couple of things from the Silent Hill series, which I really need to play. I need to play so many things. Oh, these are postcards from Bioshock Infinite. I really like these. Oh, that's the crow's thing. Oh, cool. And Devil's Kiss. Oh, this is the Enraged Songbird in the card. Wow. And then some posters of Silent Hill there. I really need to play that. Oh, that's the No Man's Soul, sorry. The other one's fine. No, not that one. That one there. There we go. Wow, this is a little bit overwhelming. I had my room nice and clean and now it's messy again. Not that I'm complaining. This has been fantastic. Thank you guys so much for all of your mail. I really appreciate it. Again, look in the description below to send me stuff, and I hope to be hearing from you guys again soon. Thank you so much, everyone. Bye.